If you're a trader, you definitely know what is the significance of bulls and bears in the whole equity trading or any sort of trading markets. Hello and Namaste Paycheck Pros. I'm Manish Hoja and this is Paycheck to Profit, India's first YouTube channel dedicated to your own financial freedom. Here on this channel, I make videos on 4th, 14th and 24th of every month where I talk to you about your financial management, your investments, your savings and how you can take multiple steps and which all lead to your financial freedom. So if you're looking to get financially free, make a lot of money through your investments, or if you just want to manage your salaries or paychecks better, this is the right channel. So it would be a great time for you to subscribe to this channel. And do not forget to hit the bell icon so that you can get notified every time I create a new video on this channel. Have you ever read a business newspaper or seen a business news channel? There are two terms that you must have heard multiple times, which is bulls and bears. Have you ever tried to figure out what exactly is the connection of bulls and bears? In today's video, I'm going to be talking to you literally about bulls and bears. If you're figuring what's wrong with me, why is Manish talking about bulls and bears on a channel that's supposed to talk about money? Well, if you're not an investor today, you will soon be. If you're a trader, you definitely know what is the significance of bulls and bears in the whole equity trading or any sort of trading markets. Bulls and bears are so important to equities and trading that Bombay Stock Exchange literally has a statue of bull right at the entrance of one of the gates. Wall Street, which is supposed to be one of the biggest trading markets of the world, it also is the house of New York Stock Exchange. There literally is a huge statue of a bull on Wall Street. So now you see, it's not a mere coincidence that you will find a bull very close to all of these equity markets. Let me tell you what exactly is the reason to place a bull and why not a bear near equity markets, and why exactly do you always talk about bulls and bears. These are market trends. So you will hear the terms bull market or bear market. When news or newspapers are talking about the bull market, what they are actually trying to say is that the market trend is going upwards. Most of the shares, or at least the indices of the stock markets, are moving up. A 20% raise or 2 months of raise in the equity markets is generally looked upon as a bull market. If you don't know what are indices, please make sure that you check the description of this video, where I'll be linking you to one of my past videos where I've spoken to you about what exactly are market indices and what is Sensex, Nifty and Bank Nifty. Similarly, when we're talking about bear markets, that's the market trend where everybody is selling. If the market index has dropped 20% or has been going down as a trend for 2 months, that is when you're looking at a bear market. At that point of time, the overall sentiment in the market is really bad. Everybody is trying to liquidate their investments. Why exactly is the term bull and bear used is really unclear, but that is the case with multiple terms in the financial market, so don't get too worried about that. One of the most commonly accepted theories is that when a bull is attacking its target, a bull always attacks with its horns, and that is why the target generally flies up. That is looking at the bull market. And a bear market? Well, a bear literally swipes its paws on the target. So that's why bear markets. I know it's a little vague, but then so is the industry. It's best to just accept it and get used to it, isn't it? So you see, Paycheck Pros, I have told you this in multiple past videos. Everything about equity markets or financial terms is just jargon, and all of these terms may sound really, really frightening when you come across them because you don't understand what is the logic behind it. But many a times the logic is either very simple or it has just become nomenclature. One of the other nomenclatures about bulls and bears, especially in Indian markets, is Tezi and Mandi. Tezi is referring to the bull market. Mandi is referring to the bear market. That's how simple it is. I hope you found the information of this video to be really helpful and interesting to you. If you did, please do not forget to like this video and share it on all the social media channels. I'm sure you have already subscribed to the channel by now. If you haven't, please do so right now. So that's about it from me in today's video. Now I'll see you in the next video. Until then, keep smiling, take care of your loved ones and stay happy. Ka-ching!